Disciplining your children is not easy, but what do you do when the discipline is as hard on you as it is on them? Welcome to Working Mom Warrior. You can call me Mocha Mom. My channel shares the ups and downs and hacks from all different moms about what it's like to juggle career and kids. We want to be that tribe of girlfriends who are ready to listen and give you tips to help you through your day. So my weekend just ended. It was a nice long holiday weekend, but filled with ups and downs, definitely. My daughter did something that I definitely told her not to do. She shouldn't have done. It was a very big infraction, and so therefore I had to ground her and take away her privileges, which included phone, car, all of that, and I told her for 4 days. So, of course, she was very upset by this, trying to talk me out of it, trying to negotiate, then just, you know, pouting about it, and beyond that, just being very disappointed that something that she had been planning for weeks, something really special she was doing with all of her friends, had to be canceled, that she couldn't go there. And so that was a problem. Obviously, she should have thought about that, and I did not want to change the discipline because of that, but I was literally sick to my stomach knowing that she was missing something that she had been planning for a while that I was excited for her to do. And it's, you know, very hard when that happens, but now, today, we got through that, and I bent a little. I did not let her go to that activity, and she eventually recognized that that was not going to happen, and she didn't even have a way to contact her friends and tell them that she wasn't going, and they probably tried reaching her. And I had her phone, and I had it in my purse, which I basically had with me all weekend. I slept with my purse so that she wouldn't try to get it, and she knew that, so I didn't even want her to be tempted to go looking for the phone. But at a certain point, I left my purse on my bed, and I was in my home office, and she saw it, and it was too tempting for her. She helped herself to it. And she contacted her friends, and she found out her friends didn't go because she was one of the ones, I think, she was the main one coordinating this. And so that particular day was a holiday. She wasn't going to go to the beach in the city with her friends to meet up with another friend who now lives down there, so that was all canceled. In the meantime, I had plans. I wanted to go out to a festival myself. It was just her and I home for the weekend. My husband's out of town. And I had a project that I wanted to work on. I didn't have to, but it's something I really wanted to do. It was a beautiful day. I did not want to be stuck in the house babysitting my 16-year-old, in essence, to make sure that she didn't do something she wasn't supposed to, didn't sneak out. At this point, she had her phone. I didn't want to wrestle it away from her. So I offered, I said, since you abided by the grounding for the last couple days and you didn't try looking for the phone that I had, you helped yourself to it, which you shouldn't have, but you found out your friends didn't end up going to this activity. I'm willing to take you and a friend to this other festival with me. You go there with me. You can go off on your own, but you leave when I leave. If you want to leave sooner, too bad. If you want to stay longer, I might consider letting you stay a little longer, but you don't go anywhere else. And she agreed to that because she was grounded and she was getting to go out. So did I make a mistake in doing that? Well, I didn't want to be home. And yes, I could have gone myself and said, hey, you're grounded. You stay in whether I'm here or not. But I would have been distracted and worried. So I was doing myself a favor in addition to her. She didn't really want to go to this festival, but she was interested in going, especially because I offered to pick up a friend. So yes, I took her and her friend and gave them money to go to the festival. And they ate. Probably something she wouldn't have done at home. She probably would have pouted and not eaten. So they ate, they walked around, they got some sunshine, which is good for you when you're, you know, feeling sad about something and just stuck in the house with the blinds pulled. So at least it got her out and I felt better. I got to work on my project. I interviewed 5 different working moms for this channel. That's what I wanted to do. I go out and do this a lot when there are public events because that's a good place to find people. It's easy to bring my camera there and talk to people. And I know it's going to get more difficult as it gets rainy and colder to find places where I can go to do this. So I really wanted to do this. And I did bend a little in bringing her, but it was convenient for me. So now here we are. The work week has started. So for the next couple days, because she's grounded, I have to drive her to work, drive her to school. We're talking about like a couple hours of driving a day over the next several days. She has her license. She's old enough to drive. She had the car last week. She was fine with it. She followed the rules. Everything was good. But do I continue the grounding, even though it's a huge inconvenience for me, taking away from my time to do work and all the other things in my life? Yes, I do. Yesterday was a different story with wanting to not be in the house all day, wanting to go to this festival and do something I wanted to do, and bringing her and getting her out. And of course today she said, well, can't I just go to Starbucks with my friend? No. So it's on a case-by-case basis. You know, I know there's a lot of people that would say it's got to be black and white. When you have a consequence, it's it no matter what. Well, I stuck to the consequence, even when it meant her missing something that she had planned for weeks, something big that would have actually helped boost her mood, being around her girlfriends, not doing anything that probably that would have gotten her in any trouble. But she missed that because she messed up on Saturday night. So she missed that on Monday. But for the next couple days, is she going to miss having the car, being able to do things she wants, seeing her friends? Yes. So sometimes I bend a little and sometimes I don't. I don't know if I'm giving you the best advice, but that is my advice. And that's what I do with this channel. This is my vlog. I'm just sharing informal ideas, but I also have a lot of great videos from other working moms, tips from them. You can watch one of them coming up and subscribe to my channel so you can see all of the videos, the profiles of working moms, how they get through their life, and the questions and answers from moms that I interview all over the place from all different backgrounds, how they cope with different issues, and inspire you because you can relate to their situations. And I talk to them about not just the things they do right, but the things they do wrong, because we all know we make mistakes. A lot of the moms watching this, I know, are the overachiever, perfectionist type moms, and you can just give yourself a little break and let yourself know that we're all making mistakes and we're all trying to wing this thing, especially in the teenage years. Good luck to you, and I look forward to hearing your thoughts in the comments. And don't forget to spread a little love to another mom who needs it.